for good connection. Okay. I'm nervous a little bit because it's my first archaeological report. And it will be difference like previous reports because I have several graphics and some chemical about some, and I'm pleased to introduce you the first result of chemical and isotopic study of middle and upper Paleolithic archaeological sites in the Arkhon Valley. This is situated in Mongolia. Central Asia is the current focus of much research because this territory was a contact zone between Western Eurasia and Eastern Asia. Yeah, you can see it here. One of the possible early human migration corridors is located in the Arkhon-Selenga mountain zone. Three stratified Paleolithic sites in the zone, Arkhon 1, Arkhon 7, and Mountain Arm, have yielded the longest cultural and stratigraphic sequence anywhere in Mongolia, including both Middle Paleolithic and Upper Paleolithic materials. Our project aimed initially at redating these relocations and understanding their paleo-environmental context. Began in 2018 with the excavation of these sites. Previous radiocarbon and ACR dates indicated that the late existence of the Middle Paleolithic here. The lithic topology also suggests persistent archaic traits in the archaic traits in the upper Paleolithic. The density and typology of artifacts suggest multiple short-term occupational episodes at the Arkhon 1 and Arkhon 7 sites, with probably butchering of medium-sized animals such as horses and sheep. The bones of large mammals included Rhinoceros, sorry, Baikal yak, and other bovids area. Mountain Arm was probably the location of long-term occupations, but archaeological material there has been heavily reworked and partially redeposited. We have identified six lithological layers from 2, 3, and 4 are deformed along one vertical line, with is probably the result of cryogenic processes. Layer 2 contains most of archaeological material that was redeposited from other strata. Preliminary OSL data support this hypothesis. There is a discrepancy between new AMS data and OSL data from layer 2 and the colluvial origin of sediments from layers 4, 5, and 6 indicate that archaeological material there was buried over a very short period of time as a result of a catastrophic event. Yeah, you can see that the age of these layers are the same. We collected many samples for various types of geochemical analysis. Unfortunately, some are still in Mongolia and inaccessible to us until the COVID pandemic allows open border once again. We analyzed the chemical composition of sediments, the distribution of rare trace and rare earth elements in layer 1, 2, 3, and 4, here one, these two graphs, are very uniform. In layer 5, the concentration of elements is twice as high. This can be explained by the difference in the lithological composition of the sediments themselves. Nevertheless, the sediments do not contain any anomalies. Trace elements are geochemically comparable to post-Archean Australian shale, indicating that they are very well mixed. And the composition of rare earth elements are similar through all sections. Moreover, variation in geochemical indication along the section are also very small. This suggests that no major climatic changes occur during the accumulation of the section. The variation in strontium isotopic composition in sediments is not so great. You can see that this varies only in fourth number after point. The strontium ratio decrease from top to bottom, also indicating the lack of sharp climate changes. Also, we can see the effect of redeposition of in layer 2 and layer 4. These two points on the graph lie outside the trend line. I believe the reason of this are include mixing and transportation of sediments. We tried to reconstruct the paleoclimate by geochemical methods. We use thorium-uranium ratio and the relationship between light and heavy rare earth elements. Both indicate a semi-arid, semi-humid climate that was more humid than at present. Now, in that region is a desert. We also analyzed a goat tooth scheme from the Archon 7 section. The strontium ratio of the animal is 0.710 and of the dentin 0.712. Since it's known that the animal of herbivores reflect the strontium isotopic composition of the grass they consume during their first years of life. However, the animal isotopic composition is different than the isotopic composition of sediments, as you can see before. We suggest that this animal grazed in a different region during their first year of life, not where they were found in the Archon Valley. We also have amassed a collection of faunal remains. We plan to conduct several tests to determine of if they were altered. If are not altered, we will analyze their strontium isotopes. Overall, our work is aimed at achieving several goals: to understand the prehistoric hunting strategies, animal migrations, and mapping of modern and ancient strontium isotopes. This is the last slide of my short presentation. Thank you for your attention.